Well, joining us on this Dundee Stars interview is Adam Morrison. And, well, unbelievable. I never thought we would see the day that we would be interviewing you here on a Dundee Stars signing interview, Adam. But, yeah, congratulations. You are a star. And the Dundee Stars fans were ecstatic when they heard that news a few short days ago. But for you, how delighted are you to be part of the team for this year?
I'm really excited. Yeah, I'm happy that there's hockey back being played in the UK. I think it's been a long year for a lot of people, and you know, for myself, I'm you know, I've spent a fair amount of time in Dundee, and you know, always enjoyed my time there, and you know, I'm really looking forward to getting things started here in September and getting the season going.
Yeah, you talk about that difficult time that everybody experienced, of course, when you were at Fife and that season ending early. Just how tough was that, and how did you guys come about finding out about that and obviously everything finishing?
Yeah, I think we were on the bus down to Coventry, I think, when the season finally got shut down. And yeah, it was kind of a weird time. You know, things were just starting to shut down and become a little more real than what they had been throughout the winter there. And I don't think anybody expected it to last as long as it did, and certainly not have the, well, at least in the hockey world, we didn't expect it to have the fallback that it did. But it's been, you know, a long couple of, or I guess 20 months or so, and at the end of the day, I think everybody's happy that they're going to get the opportunity to get back on the ice and you know, show everybody that we haven't lost a step or two.
Yeah, 100%. So we'll get into your previous career before you arrived in the Elite League shortly, but what was your perception of the Elite League before you joined Fife Flyers in that 1920 season?
I knew that the hockey was going to be good, but it was my first time over in Europe, and I wasn't quite sure what to expect. But coming from the East Coast League, and some time or some experience in the American Hockey League, in terms of level of play, there wasn't much of a drop off. I would say the league was just a little older than the East Coast League. The East Coast League is very similar to in terms of pace, but you know, the EIHL just has more experience, I would say. And then you add the bigger rink and it allows guys to have a little more space, time and space out there and create different options but as far as the level of play, there was no drop off, and it was a really great experience.
And a number of tough opponents in the league, of course. There is the teams that are always classed as the top guys in the league, but something special around this area, of course, is we've got the Scottish teams quite closely together. Of course, there's the rivalry between Fife and Glasgow, Dundee and Glasgow, but there is also the Fife Dundee games, and they're always tough games where they really come close on all the encounters. What's your memories of them from the season when you were in the opposite colours?
Yeah, I think, like you say, just tough games. Both teams, we were both in similar positions. You know, at the halfway point where we both needed to, create an identity and find ways to win games, because, you know, in the first half, you know, with only 10 teams in the league and obviously eight making playoffs, it, you know, there's a little bit there, you can make up a lot of ground, but you can also lose a lot of ground quickly. So, you know, for the games that we played against Dundee, you know, they were always very competitive. The atmosphere was always a lot of fun to be a part of. You've got two groups of very passionate fans that care deeply about their clubs, and you know, that's kind of, for me, that's what makes this sport worth playing, is playing in front of fans and you know, providing some entertainment.
Yeah, I'll get into the fans in just a second, but if we can touch on the two coaches at Fife, who are good friends of Dundee Stars TV. Of course, the assistant coach at Fife, being the former coach here, player. But what was it like working under Jeff Hutchins and Todd Dutton?
They were great. Yeah, I had, you know, they gave me a lot of freedom to control my schedule and make sure that I was getting everything that I needed in order to prepare to play every single weekend. And you know, we had from my perspective, a very good relationship. You know, we both sides were upfront and honest throughout the season. And you know, I think they, you know, we had our struggles as a team, but they consistently, you know, they consistently showed up and helped prepare us for every single weekend, and you know, didn't, you know, sometimes when you go through skids, you know, you grasp at straws to change things up in hopes of a different result, but you know, for the most part, we kept our identity the same and just tried to stick with it. And in hockey, it's you know, and especially in this league, there's a lot of parity and every team, any team can win on any given night. So, you know, although we struggled at points, I felt like we always put forth an effort that was, you know, giving ourselves an opportunity to win, and Jeff and Todd were instrumental in that.
When your announcement happened, it was very unusual, but because you don't normally see it when it's players joining rivalry teams like that. But there was for the most part, a lot of praise for yourself from the Fife Flyers fans. There was a lot of good well wishes to you. I mean, just how good were you in that season you were at Fife?
Yeah, well, and they, you know, like I said, the fans are why we want to play this game. You know, they're the reason we can play this game for a living. Without them, you know, we wouldn't be able to make a living at it. So, you know, that my time there, everybody treated me extremely well. Like I said, they're a very passionate group, and they care about their club, and they also, you know, they don't, because it's a smaller organization, it's easy to become familiar with the fans and develop relationships, which to me is you know, not something you always get to do when you're a part of a bigger organization. And I think that's what makes Fife, and I'm sure Dundee is the same, so special, is that you get to actually become a part of the community, and you're not just seen as you know, seen as an athlete, you're seen as part of that community.
Yeah, that's a great response. And just for any Stars fans who think I'm doing an interview about Fife Flyers, Let's move on to Dundee. Sorry. Yeah. I thought it was some questions just to cover, and I think it's quite interesting for anyone watching the interview just about that time there. So how did the move come about to Dundee then with Coach Omar Pasha? How did he get your signature?
It came together pretty quickly. I had made my intentions clear that I had wanted to return and play this year. And it was kind of a last minute thing that came together with Dundee. I had planned to return to Fife originally. Unfortunately, this is a business, and they made a decision to go a different route. When the writing, or, you know, writing became clear on the wall that they were leaning towards a different direction, I knew if I wanted to play, I needed to look after my own interests. That's when I got in touch with Omar, and we had a couple of really good chats. Like I said, Dundee, the time I spent up there, I was, I always really enjoyed my time there, felt it was a great little city, I felt like I always seemed to enjoy playing in that building as well, just came together pretty quickly, but really happy that we were able to get something worked out.
Yeah, I mean, a great signing from all of us and our thoughts and the fans. One of the areas you touched on there earlier was about the community aspect, and of course Dundee Stars is a huge club in terms of being part of the community and do regular work even in the off season throughout. And I'm sure from what we've heard about yourself, that's something that really interests you and something you'll really want to be part of here in Dundee.
Oh, for sure. I think it's important. Like I said, without the community and without the fans, we wouldn't have jobs. So I think it's important to give back, part of why we as hockey players, or at least from North America, we come overseas is to get some life experience in a different country, you can't do that unless you immerse yourself in the community and inside the culture.
And for yourself, this year, you've had that experience now in the Elite League. What are you hoping to pursue and do this year with the Dundee Stars? What's your personal goals? And what's the coach put on you in terms of pressure?
He hasn't put any more pressure than any other club that I've played for has in the past. I think as a goaltender, your job is to stabilize the back end and help give the team in front of you a chance to win on every single night. Besides the obvious of, maintaining good statistics, I don't really have any personal goals other than, to show up every single day, work hard and make sure I'm doing my job, which is, giving my team a chance to win. I think if you're doing that as a goaltender, the numbers will take care of themselves. At the end of the day, the most important statistic in our stat line is wins. If you can help elevate your team to A, make it into the playoffs, then it's a short playoff series. Anything can happen, and you can make some noise.
Now, at this point in the interview, I normally ask you for a message for the fans, but we've got something to do for the fans first. During the pandemic, the club set up the Dundee Stars Gold Club, And the club's forever grateful to the fans who consistently dedicate their subscriptions to that and being members of that. And well, of course, some of them will know, maybe some of them don't, but you will be sponsored by the Dundee Stars Gold Club this year. And earlier, a couple of months ago, the club announced that there would be a competition to win the Starskate jersey as part of a promotion for the members of the club. So right now, Adam, I would ask you to do a drum roll if you had a drum kit there, but I don't think you do.
I just don't have any. I don't have any rhythm, so that's the real issue.
And our budget didn't come with special effects for drum kits. So let's roll to the draw now, and let's find a lucky winner of the Dundee Stars Gold Club competition for the Starskate jersey. Well, congratulations to Ella Dempster, who has won Starsky's jersey. It's a big jersey, by the way, Adam. I think it actually is for me, which is quite a shock looking at the size of me. But congratulations to Ella on winning that one.
Well, congratulations, Ella. I look forward to meeting you and seeing you in your new jersey.
Definitely. Well, I'm going to ask you one final question. It's not about Fife, don't worry, or anything else. I just want to ask you if you've got one final message, Adam, for the fans before we end the interview.
Just thank you for the warm welcome. I'm really excited about the upcoming season. I'm looking forward to meeting everybody and hopefully providing some entertainment and a few wins along the way.
Yeah, well, we're delighted to have you. And one thing we have to do before we end actually as well is just tell the fans that you can still join the Gold Club. And if you get your membership signed up for by, I think it's the 5th of September, you will guarantee yourself your name on the wall, the Stronger Together wall in the Dundee Ice Arena. So sign up for that. And of course, if you haven't got a season ticket yet, get signed up for that as well to see Adam in every home game this season. I'm sure he would be delighted to have your support as the rest of the team would. But Adam, finally, again, thank you very much for doing the interview. We are all delighted to have you and can't wait to see you as a star this season.
I'm looking forward to it. And thanks for having me.